Let's see. Today is Thursday. It's about 4:40 in the evening, June 14th. Gonna go outside and take a look around. It seems awfully quiet out there right now. It's cooled off a bit. It's been running around 100 degrees, but now we've got some overcast skies. And it's dropped down to about 90, which is actually kind of nice. Got a couple things transplanted out here. Let's see, what was it? Oh, tomatoes. You would probably need a magnifying glass to see them back there. They're tiny little two-leaf things, but just means they have potential. Squash is starting to fill out a little bit. I put in some, transplanted the tiny little bits of, let's see, zoom this out a little bit more, cauliflower around the parsley here. I've got, I think, 3 or 4 little clumps of it there. So we'll see how that does. My garlic is looking even worse. I don't know if it's going to come back. I think I've decided to just leave it in the ground all summer and maybe all winter out here, and we'll see what happens. The rose bushes look great. Always love to see flowers on the rose bushes. Comfrey's doing good. It liked the transplant, so this is a good thing. My flowering cherry tree is definitely dead, I think. I think I can safely conclude that that is dead. Those are spearmint. I'd like to get them transplanted into this area with the lilies again, but I need some more good soil for this spot, so we will see how that goes. I had to put up some fencing, I don't know if you see this, to try and keep the turkeys in, to make the management happy. That poor old turkey mom has just been run ragged by those babies. And I'm just gonna let the carrots and Swiss chard go to seed over here. I didn't get anything off of them. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It's probably only 6 carrots in there, so it's not even worth pulling them up. Still haven't finished the pond, as you can see. That may not get finished for a while. since I had to swipe most of the fencing from around my lettuce bed, the turkeys have pretty much wiped out what was coming up in the lettuce bed. So I'm either going to have to re-fence it or do something here. I've got a couple of ideas, but I don't know. It has gotten so hot. I don't think anything can even grow in this heat. If the lettuce had come up, it probably would have immediately bolted. I did find again that one peach that seems to be growing on the peach tree. I don't know if I can zoom in here. I may have it in the shot. It's hard to see. Yes, I decided to use what I had to try and deal with those ground squirrels that were eating all the food. I've gotten two of them so far. Boysenberries are growing quite a bit this year. Don't think I'll get anything from the boysenberry plants, but at least they're growing now, so that's something. It's all right, guys. It's just me. Go look at the apple tree, even though it's gonna upset the babies. It's all right, guys. I put a bunch more diatomaceous earth on the apple tree here. Try and protect my apples. I see a spot here. What is that? Oh, it was a flying thing. Some of the apples are looking kind of good, but others don't seem to be growing much, so maybe that's their natural selection. Raspberries are coming back, but slowly. Even with the feed that I gave them. Probably getting chewed down to nothing two times in a row didn't help. The little tiny grapevine that I transplanted here a couple of years back is growing. Clearly not getting enough water. I moved the soaker hose so it could at least end here. I thought there'd be enough water running downhill, but don't think it was getting enough. The bush cherries are growing. Sure wish I would have got some cherries up with them this year. This container here is a bit of an experiment. I put it in the pond to see if having water to the bottom of it would help things sprout better. But it didn't. I did get some sprouts, so I pulled it out, moved it over here. Got an onion in there. I transplanted my cucumber and two tomatoes. And there was a fourth thing in there that has been eaten off, I see. I can't remember what. Oops, there was more tomatoes. My diatomaceous earth did not stop whatever it was from chewing off the tops. I can't remember if that was basil. I think that was basil I put in the front that's now a tiny little stick. And I know I put more tomatoes in there than that. Okay. Diatomaceous earth does not protect new plants from everything. These guys seem to be doing okay. Sunflowers and squashes and whatever. And those guys are doing okay. You can really tell the different soil, I think, has given me different results. Some of the soil was redder than other. You can see by the amount of green. Some of them are a deep green. And some of them are kind of a yellowish green, which means I probably need more fertilizer or something in those there buckets. Hello, popcorn. Oh, hello there, Robin. I didn't see you back there. Where's that peanut? That's a peanut. And that one's doing okay. Blackberries are coming back, actually thicker and quicker than I thought they were going to. Who's doing all that fussing over there? That's everything except for the almond and the grapes over here. We'll come over here. This is a Washington hawthorn that I put in. And it seems to be blooming up there. Never seen that before. And I have a small Washington hawthorn next to it that I planted these several years ago, many years ago, and I put all the thorn bushes along the edge. That's why I've got the roses along that fence line, and I put the blackberries on that line, and the raspberries here, and the hawthorn bushes here. That I could have a wall of thorns around my yard if I were so inclined. I could close things off. I don't know if you can see these. A lot of almonds on these. This here tree. See all those? A lot of grapes getting started on here. Take it down a little bit more. that they're all keeping close tabs on these grapevines here. I wonder why. I moved again because of the Yeah, you're going in the right direction. Come on, there, go over this way. Come on. Come on. Come on, it's over here. Come on, guys. Come on. Come on. Come on, Blue. Come on. Come on, the food's over here. Come on, Blue. Come on, little peeps. Come on, guys. Come on, Blue. Come on. Okay, I'm gonna close it off right there.